skyscraper that is kind of the signature of New York City. Coming up, Felix Tito Trinidad and William Joppy as we go to Joppy's dressing room. 32-1, one draw, 24 knockouts. He is the reigning middleweight champion of the world. But tonight he'll be treated like a stepchild to this guy. He was undefeated. 39-0, 32 knockouts. A kid with a great jab and a great left hook. All right, Mark, you've got a feature on these guys.
Yeah, we certainly did. You know, Joppy Colonel is the champion, but like you said earlier tonight, it's Felix Trinidad that makes this fight. He's working to put his name on yet another new championship belt. Joppy, despite holding this middleweight title, WBA title, for some 5 years, is working just to get his name finally known, period, outside the world of boxing, and only one will succeed tonight.
William Joppy's time has come. Since winning the WBA version of the middleweight title back in 1996, all Joppy dreamed about was unifying the division and reigning as the best boxer in the world pound for pound. Tonight, he is finally on the road to fulfilling that dream, and he can thank his opponent, Felix Trinidad, for that. After all, it was because of Trinidad's move up to the 160-pound division that this middleweight unification series was created. Now Joppy has a chance to fight the marquee name and put himself in the position he's always wanted to be.
My goal, I want to get on that pound for pound list. You know, I've been champion for 5 years and I don't get the credit that I deserve because I haven't fought the marquee opposition. I fought guys that are great fighters, but they didn't have a name. So I need a Felix Trinidad. You know, Felix Trinidad had Oscar De La Hoya, he had the Pernell Whitakers. That's why he has that name. This is my dream come true, to show that I belong on that pound-for-pound list.
For Trinidad, winning this middleweight unification series would solidify his place in boxing history as the first ever universally recognized seven-time world champion. Seven world titles, champion in three different weight divisions, welterweight, super welterweight, and middleweight. That will truly be a huge step in my career. A great record in the sport of boxing.
It's a record that can only be accomplished if Trinidad wins his next two fights. Tonight, he takes the first step against Joppy, who promises to give Tito everything he can handle and then some.
I'm going to bang with him. People tell me not to stand in front of Trinidad. I'm going to stand in front of him. You know what I mean? I'm going to give him slug. I'm going to box him. I'm going to do everything. I'm going to give him everything I possibly can do. I'm going to back him up. I'm going to back up. So, I mean, if I'm going to give Trinidad what he gives me. I'm going to take everything he gives me.
Joppy is a fighter who's always in great condition. He's a boxer who throws a lot of punches, a lot of quick punches. But on a negative side, in my opinion, he fights with his hands way too low. I'm taller than he is, so I'm going to use my reach advantage to the fullest and punish him in the early stages of the fight.
WBC and IBF middleweight champion Bernard Hopkins will be watching tonight's fight very closely. He gets the winner on September 15th at Madison Square Garden, and he feels that this fight is not a lock for either Trinidad or Joppy.
Dangerous fight for Trinidad, but a winnable fight. Why? Because Trinidad, I think, is a bigger guy. Definitely hits harder than Joppy, but Joppy's crafty. He got that D.C., Washington, D.C. in it. Ray Leonard, slick, pest you all day. Joppy have to box a master plan. No street fight with Trinidad. A master plan. Boxing when you want to slug, slugging when you want to box.
Now he's dealing with a veteran now at 160. So I think he's biting off a little more than what he can chew.
I believe that this fight will not go the distance. I'm coming in ready for anything. I'm coming in ready to win. William Joppy's a great champion, but I also have to tell him that I'm coming to win, and I'm coming to take your title.
All right, there you have it, William Joppy and Felix Trinidad. This thing really is going to start right away because I don't know that the introduction to this fight. We're going to have one fighter come in. We're going to have the national anthems played, both national anthems, and then we're going to have the WBA champion, William Joppy, come in. I don't think I've ever remembered seeing a fight, certainly never covering a fight, but seeing a fight where this is going to happen. But again, it's a spectacular thing. It's Madison Square Garden. It's New York City. It's championship boxing, so anything at all can happen. Joining us for this fight is going to be Bernard Hopkins. And Colonel, I'm just the goosebumps are starting for this fight.
Well, as I said at the very top of the show, this is the type of fight, as you see Bernard Hopkins with us now. And Bernard, we certainly want to thank you for joining us. You are holding two of the middleweight championship belts now. Who do you want to win this fight?
Well, I'm rooting for Trinidad, not only because of the financial rewards, but the status that he had built up from the welterweights all the way up to the middleweights. But I know it's going to be a tough fight. I know Joppy is not going to just lay down and give his title up. But I think with the crowd here, the Latin crowd is giving Trinidad the support, and I'm looking to fight the best one that wins.
Now, Bernard, when you talk about the financial considerations, let's make it clear to the public, they're considerable financial considerations. We're talking about $1 million here. That's a lot of geld.
You're talking about $1 million rich or $1 million poor. And, yes, I want to fight Trinidad. Well, I want to fight Trinidad and hopefully win because he brings an extra million to the pot.
Now, Mark talked about a couple of things just before the feature and just after the feature, and that was the situation with the national anthem. Felix Tito Trinidad, who uses the crowd to get juiced up as he begins to make his way in, I assume that this, as I see the Puerto Rican flag, that Tito is making his way in now because the crowd is going absolutely bonkers, but I see nothing but American flags coming in, and I expected to see certainly the Puerto Rican flags flying here, or maybe they're just bringing those in to set up for the national anthem. But nonetheless, Tito's going to be in when they play the anthem of Puerto Rico and the American national anthem, and Joppy's going to stay outside and make some sort of grand entry himself.
Yeah, that's something totally different than I've seen in my 13 year of boxing. The way you look at it now, it looks like Joppy's coming out first. But I think it's more of a mental, or more of a strategy, maybe on both sides, to see who would get impatient, who would get off their game plan mentally. And when it's all said and done, it won't even matter. It's about who wants to be the undisputed middleweight champion of the world. And a lot of this is just a posturing to see who would give up mentally before the fight even starts.
Now, Bernard, as a former professional athlete myself, and you, of course, as an active professional athlete, I've found that in contact sports, once the first hit happens in football or hockey, or the first punch in boxing, you revert back to what you trained for, you're ready to go, and all this hype, you know, the butterflies kind of disappear, and it's down to business. I mean, this is your life. When you're a fighter, you're not frightened like a guy who might be having one fight in his whole life who was just threatened by some guy in the street. This is what you do.
Once the guy punches you, it becomes a fight. And most times it ain't a clean fight. But yes, you train hard, you focus, you run, you sleep, you eat, you think boxing. And yes, when the first bell ring of the fight, you go in there and you want to execute, you want to put all your work into the ring for that particular time and show the people that you are the true champion that you are.
Hey, well, I want to tell you folks that are watching at home, as you take a look at the audience in attendance here, this place is some kind of rocket. They came to see Felix Trinidad, and here is Felix Tito Trinidad, the great former welterweight champion of the world, making his way, and the crowd will see him momentarily make his way into the ring. And Tito Trinidad comes in here undefeated. He's a pride of Coupe Alto in Puerto Rico. He's 39-0, 32 knockouts. This is a kid with a great left jab, a great left hook. This kid is always in fantastic shape. He's a kid whose dad has trained him to the point where he's able to handle his success. Look at the smile on his face. That's a relaxed guy. Bernard, you go the other way. You wear the executioner outfit. You come in. You have kind of a snarl on your face. Both of you have different ways of going to your office. I'll put it that way.
Yes, everybody have, at least myself and Trinidad, as you see smiling, have their own style. He wants people to know that he's confident, that he's ready, and that he's going to deliver. Bernard Hopkins is different. I come out with the mask. I don't want them to see my face. I want them to be in suspense of the execution that's going to take place.
Well, it works for you, and for him, he loves this. There are very few fighters in the history of the sport about Mike Goldberg, then enjoy the, let's say, the stage that this guy is coming to, which is the boxing ring. Listen to this crowd, Mark.
Unbelievable. You don't know what thing that, the one thing that amazes me, Bernard, this guy was a perfect welterweight. He looked sensational as a super welterweight. Now at 160 pounds, he looks like he was a natural middleweight.
Yes, Trinidad has been walking around at high 60s, 68, 69, 70 for the last two or three years. And he couldn't fight it anymore, and he finally came up. If he was at the weigh-in, you see Trinidad looked bigger than Joppy. It was like a reversal. It was like Joppy was the guy moving up, and Trinidad was the guy sitting there all alone.
Is this the summit of where his body can go? Can he go any further up? Can he go maybe one more time?
I think he does. I think he can. I think he can get up to 68 and be comfortable. I don't see him fighting and being strong at 75 at light heavy. But yes, I see him getting up at least 68, 69, and still being effective.
He's still young. It's not like he's an old fighter and you can't put your body through that kind of metamorphosis anymore. So he does have that going for him. But he, no matter what weight he fights at, he just looked like he's a natural doing it.
And he has the boxing frame.
All right, I see Jimmy Lennon Jr. moving into position, and we should have the official announcements, because remember, we're going to have the Puerto Rican anthem first and the American national anthem second, and all that will happen momentarily because it's Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we continue with our action at this time, I'd like to ask you to rise for the singing of the national anthems. In the ring, ladies and gentlemen, first to lead us in the national anthem of Puerto Rico, please welcome recording artists Amba. Singing sensation Margot Lenski.
Stripes and bright stars.
William Joppy. Of course, he didn't get the crowd reaction that you'd expect. But there you see Trinidad, a little bit taller, a little bit heavier, 2 years younger, an inch and a half reach advantage. They're both coming off wins, and then you see it in the metric system. Unified rules, 10-point must, no standing eight, no three knockdown rule. And now let's go to our ring announcer, Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Welcome you to the world's most famous arena, Madison Square Garden in New York City, for the featured bout of the evening, the second round in the World Middleweight Championship Series. And it's all brought to you by Don King Productions in association with Madison Square Garden, TVKO, and Budweiser, the undisputed king of beers. This bout coming away is sanctioned by the World Boxing Association. President Gilberto Mendoza, Supervisor Aurelio Fiengo, along with the New York State Athletic Commission, the Chairman Mel Southard, Commissioners Jerome Becker and Mark Kornstein. Introducing to you our three judges scoring this bout from ringside. From Johannesburg, South Africa, Stanley Christodoulou. From Montreal, Quebec, Canada, Guy Jutras. And from Ardsley, New York, Malvina Lathan. And the third man to the ring, our referee in charge of this bout, working in this, his 16th world title bout, Arthur Mercante. All right, fans, here we go with our main event of the evening, 12 rounds of boxing for the WBA Middleweight Championship of the World. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance and boxing fans joining us around the world, live from Madison Square Garden, it's time for the main event of the evening. Introducing to you first the challenger on my left, fighting out of the blue corner, entering the ring wearing red trunks with blue and white trim, hailing from and representing Coupe Alto, Puerto Rico. He weighed in at 159¼ pounds, undefeated in his campaign in the ring with 39 wins, no losses, 32 big wins coming by way of knockout. Here is the four-time world champion who currently holds the IBF and WBA super welterweight crowns. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome El Gran Campeón Puerto Riqueño, introducing Felix Tito Trinidad. And his opponent across the ring is the defending world champion on my right, fighting out of the red corner, entering the ring wearing red, white, and blue trunks, fighting out of Seabrook by way of Lincoln Park, Maryland. He weighed in at a ready 158¾ pounds. His record stands at 32 wins, one loss and one draw, with 24 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight he is making the eighth defense of his title. Here is the two-time and current WBA middleweight champion of the world, introducing William Joppy. And once again, a referee in charge, Arthur Mercante, now to give instructions, 12 rounds of boxing scheduled.
Let's get everybody out first. Let's get everybody out of the ring first. Just a chief second. Just a chief second. Good evening, Felix. Good evening, William. You both received the rules earlier tonight by the New York State Athletic Commission. I expect a nice, clean fight. Touch gloves. Good luck to the both of you.
Hey, how you doing?
All right, again, it's unified rules. No three knockdown rule, 10-point must scoring. No standing eight count. A fighter cannot be saved by the bell in any round. Only the referee can stop the fight. If there's any accidental fouls, we get into those rules as we get going. Bob Sheridan, along with Bernard Hopkins and Mark Goldberg here. Here we go. In the red, white, and blue striped trunks is William Joppy. And Joppy, the middleweight champion of the world, says he must pressure Tito Trinidad early. And that's what he will try to do. Tito, who has been in more pressure fights against De La Hoya, feels the right hand of William Joppy. early here now, Bernard.
Yes, he did it early, and he landed that right hand. Trinidad is suspect to right hands.
Well, we'll see if he can land it more. A little bit side-to-side movement now. Circling around to the right is Tito Trinidad. Light left hand taken on the gloves of Trinidad. Joppy digs down, stays hard. Lights up that light left hand, taps Trinidad on the forehead. A lot of questions about whether Trinidad can step up and take the shot from a middleweight. We talked about the extended career as a 147-pound welterweight that Trinidad had, where he trained down from a street walking, probably 175. So this is not as big a jump as you may think for this guy who's cruised through a couple of weight divisions the past couple of years. Tito hasn't opened up in the first round yet, though.
No, he hasn't. I think that Trinidad is trying to get his rhythm. He's trying to get his punches in line. And that's when Joppy should do what he's just doing now. I mean, what he's doing now, he's throwing a jab, and he's trying to put the pressure on Tito.
Well, that's Tito with the first big left hook. He doesn't really land it heavily, but right back to the body is William Joppy. Joppy bangs high to the body that time. Didn't hurt Trinidad because he's in tremendous physical condition. Remember, both of these guys are guys that love to train, that are in great shape.
Joppy must get the respect from Trinidad early. And that's what Joppy realized. He realized that he got to come to Trinidad and try to put some hurt on Trinidad to make Trinidad respect him.
Almost 2 minutes gone here in the first round of this middleweight championship fight, and the crowd in attendance here in Madison Square Garden absolutely loves this. So far, this is Joppy's first round. He hasn't landed anything viciously, but he's landed more. He's dictating the flow of the fight. Nice counter punch right hand, that time by Trinidad. You'll hear any time that Trinidad does anything, the crowd go absolutely crazy. This is the left hand, soars the right hand to the chin of William Joppy. Another right hand. I thought it might have buckled the knees for a second of Joppy, but he was just standing awkwardly. Inside of 39, 38 seconds to go in the first round, and now Joppy has felt some power from Tito Trinidad. Now this round is about even.
The tie has changed. Trinidad now to know that he got Joppy hurt, and that he wants to go ahead and try to put more hurt on Joppy. Joppy must now at least use the jab and keep his hands up.
Big left hook is strong, puts Joppy down. He's back on his heels, and down he goes. And he really wobbles. He's hurt. It's up to 4, 5, 6, 7. Joppy's going to have a tough time recovering in between rounds. Right on top of Trinidad. He's ready to go again. And he hangs on for life. And the bell ends. Round one.
Got the spirits of Joppy. He held Trinidad because he knew he didn't have anything and he was hurt. And he knew he'd be knocked out. That's the experience that Joppy has that Vargas didn't have, but he's serious in trouble.
Bernard, this is the first time that Tito has worn 10-ounce gloves. He's always worn 8-ounce gloves. That might be a reason why, right here.
It is a reason why. It was a left foot. You see where Joppy's hands was at? His hands was down at his waist, and he got hit with a left foot. Down again, he got hit with a left foot.
And he's really down. His eyes are rolling back. He's all jellied. Watch this now, Bernard.
He sets him up with a left foot, and then he throws the right hand and hit him with another left foot on the way back. Joppy hands is down at his waist.
That last shot was a vicious knockdown. I'm going to tell you, folks, no fighter can recover from a knockdown that heavy. Joppy is going to have a lot of trouble surviving the second round. This answers the questions of the power of Trinidad at the middleweight level.
He's definitely a middleweight, and he definitely has the power.
This could be his natural size, too, Bernard.
You're right.
All right, here we go. Round number two. Can Joppy recover? His legs are still loose in the knees. So my question is, he hasn't answered, as far as I can see, the ability to recover in between rounds. And Tito knows it. He's jabbing more, throws the right hand, whistle past the left ear of William Joppy. Joppy takes a straight left hand on the jaw. Joppy's got his hands down. Remember what Bernard said about that. With those hands down, he's wide open for the left hook. He's trying to get the circulation going. Listen to the crowd chant Tito. Tito, round number two. Joppy already down in the first round. Tito just stands right in front of him, looking for the opportunity to land the big left hand.
Joppy right now has to be real careful. He's being aggressive, but he still don't have his bearings in the stage. If I was Joppy, I'd be dancing, boxing, and buying some time. Buying a round or two so I can get my bearings and come back and start fighting harder again.
Boy, he's really got his hands down long. He's wide open for that overhand, looping right hand by Tito. Tito clips him again upstairs. Tito knows that. Joppy's hands are extremely low, especially that left hand. He's open for the right hand of Tito Trinidad, and you've already seen him land the left hook. There's a straight right hand again.
This
landed right on the jaw of William Joppy. Joppy comes forward, tries to throw the uppercut.
This reminds me of Trinidad and David Reed
when he was punishing him. This is the punishment right now. And Joppy must now try to figure out how he's going to survive at least another round or two to get his legs. He's moving, he's shaking his arms. He has to do this because he knows his body is feeling heavy and limp.
All right, action continues here in the second round. Those are the comments of Bernard Hopkins, the reigning middleweight champion. I want to say the other middleweight champion, but he has two of the belts. Looping right hand through by William Joppy. Tito being very patient now. Joppy now appears to be totally recovered. In the early seconds, he survived. I want to ask you this. Why didn't Tito attack him more in that second round in the early going?
Because Tito realized that Joppy is a full-fledged middleweight, and he just wanted to buy his time until he get the right left hook in there. Trinidad is known for not being having that killer instinct, but he will punish you and beat you up. But he's letting Joppy come back into the fight. And this will become now a struggle on who's going to give in.
Well, that happened in the Vargas fight, too. He knocked him down in the early going and was able to do it again, and then it became a war. Joppy really, really needs to knock him down to get some respect, because Tito is filled with confidence right now. Wow, with a left hand as Tito Trinidad. He goes back with a right hand, trying to get inside, lands a right hand. Joppy back at his heels again. Joppy's got those hands down, and they're down low enough as he loads up the right hand and misses. Tito has got great positioning. He's just outside the powerful shots of William Joppy, which Joppy has yet to been able to land. In the closing seconds now, the second round of the fight. This is a good Tito Trinidad round, although he didn't lose his cool in the early going. He looks into the ground chance. Tito, as the seconds tick away to end the second round of the fight.
I don't like the way Joppy keeps his hands down after exchanges. He got to keep his hands up. If he don't keep his hands up, even though he might hit Trinidad, he'll get hit with a left foot pouring out of the clinch.
But this is the way, looking at some of Joppy's fights, this is the way his hands are all the time. It appears that his hands are always down, and I was even wondering prior to the fight the last couple days what Tito would do to take advantage of the fact that Joppy does not keep his hands up and sometimes keeps them straight out like this, almost a pitter-patter thing. Maybe he can do that against Jonathan Reed, but he can't do that against Felix Trinidad.
He can't do that to one of the greatest fighters that come up from the welterweights to the middleweights because his reflexes, and Trinidad is not going to let him do this.
Oh, yeah, good right hand right there.
And look what Joppy hands drops after exchanges.
He's wide open for that right hand, it appears to me, throughout the course of the first couple of rounds of this fight. Here we go, round three, Bob Sheridan with Bernard Hopkins and Mark Goldberg, the principals in the ring.
Watch your heads.
The reigning middleweight champion of the world, William Joppy Jr., along with the man seated next to me, Bernard Hopkins, who has two of the belts. This is for the WBA middleweight title. And Felix Trinidad wants the lift, and he had the champ on his rear in the first round already, and it was a vicious knockdown. All right, Tito showing patience here in the third round as he goes with a straight left hand. That's the right hand again. Hits Joppy, spins the head. Joppy comes back, throws a light right hand, and then a left hook of his own. Tito up on his toes. You can see the adrenaline rush as he feints lefts right in front. He's getting great angles there, Bernard.
He's stepping side to side, and he's getting great angles. He's throwing that left hook hard.
There's that right hand again. He sees it. It's open all the time. When Tito pressures him inside, Joppy has that left hand down. He's wide open for the right. Dixon shot right in the car. Body.
Okay.
Yeah, and Mercante Jr., Arthur Mercante Jr. says, hey, keep it up, Tito. The crowd moves to tell them to keep it clean. But you were right, you know. He does some slick things with elbows and low blows. That's all part of it, Bernard, as you well know.
That's boxing. Once a guy hits you, it becomes dirty.
Wow, with a left hand. Nice defensive tactics and movements by Tito Trinidad. This is why he's such a good boxer. Two feigning left hands, and Tito makes a miss. This has got to be frustrating for Joppy.
It's really frustrating. Look where Joppy's left hand at every time he's jabbed. And Trinidad realized that. Now he's coming with the left hook, and then he hit him with the right hand. The left hand is down at his waist, and Trinidad is countering that.
That right hand, almost a desperation shot by Joppy here in round number three. Tito just right on his fight plan, taking the best that Joppy has to throw and making him miss, and ducks underneath the wild right hand and then slips the left hand. He's right in front of him now, looking to throw a right hand. He'll set it up off the left jab off. If Joppy drops that right, left hand, he'll counter it with a right hand of his own. Watch it. As he comes in, Tito tries to move into position for the right hand. Instead, he goes for the left hook. That hook is a very powerful left hook. He has power in both hands. Great, great training. Just Joppy lands a big shot. Joppy actually having a pretty good go here for the last minute or so in this round.
but he still have to be careful because Trinidad is waiting to, after the clinches are broken, to throw a right hand or a left hook.
One thing that's noticeable is the slick movement that Trinidad has with his head and body and trunk, and how he rolls when he does get punched. See the up and down movement? Joppy now landing shots.
It's clear that Joppy is not a big puncher because he hit Trinidad with three or four good shots and Trinidad didn't budge.
He just walks right through. Joppy comes with the uppercut.
Right.
And now he has the hang on. He's tired from throwing shots now. I don't know. Joppy may have won that round.
Yes, he won the round.
Theo lands the heavier blows again in the closing seconds. They're really going at it. Nice job by Mercante to get in there so nobody lands a punch after the bell. I'll tell you this. I like to see the American referees go in. You see the European referees, and they're so tentative. Things happen at the end of rounds that shouldn't happen.
Exactly.
I think it's evident also that Joppy is completely recovered from that first round, although the colonel mentioned that after the first 30 or 40 seconds of the second round that he thought he was recovered. But this was a good round for Joppy. I think the first round has already been forgotten.
Felix Trinidad Sr. has just told, as we take a look at this replay from the third round, don't get desperate. Just continue to fight. Stay cool. That's the coolness of being in big fights that's coming from that corner.
Oh, another thing that Bernard said in the third round, that he took a couple punches and hit Trinidad and didn't seem to really be bothered by the punch of a middleweight.
All right, here we go with round number four. This is scheduled for 12 rounds. Joppy tries to attack Trinidad. You heard Trinidad's dad say that, you know, just don't panic. Don't jump on anything.
Watch out. Let's keep it clean now.
Nice left hand in the face of Joppy. Joppy catches him with a light left hand. Trinidad seemingly doesn't have a lot of respect for the punching power of William Joppy. And again, you see Joppy landing shots, but it doesn't take any toll. Trinidad throws punches with bad intentions.
I mentioned earlier that Joppy has to be careful. After the clinch, he pulls out with his hands down.
And the same thing happens when they're in tight, too. When he steps back, he's throwing. So Tito throws coming in. Nice uppercut that time by Tito. Straight right hand again. Has the right hand again on the air. That time he might have rocked Joppy. He's back on his heels. Joppy's on his heels and he's hurt. Hot dog drops him. For the second time, he's down. That's only the third time in his career. He may not be able to recover. It's up to six and seven and eight and nine. His eyes are still glassing. They're going to let it continue. That's it, the right hand, light right hand gets through. And almost a low, it's just on instinct that Joppy's fighting now. He survived about 50 seconds now, and there's 55 seconds to go in this round. Tito looking for the big shot, lines him up, trying to push it back, comes with the uppercut. Joppy a whole lot more recovered than I thought he'd be at this stage. Nailed with another right hand. He's back on his heels again. 40 seconds to go in the fourth round. Trinidad comes forward, trying to finish this thing off. Wow, with a left hand is Tito. Joppy runs away from him.
His hands are down. That's where he gets in trouble at. See, his hands is down. Trinidad's going to set and throw a hard right hand, and he's back down in trouble again.
There's the right hand behind the ear. Exactly as Bernard said. Wow, with that left hand, whistles past the nose of Joppy. But Trinidad knows that left hand is coming down. Lines him up with the right hand. Bangs him by the ear. 9 seconds to go in this round, and Joppy has survived. Inside of 5 seconds, it's incredible. At 140, I didn't think Joppy could survive the fourth round. But a big round for Tito Trinidad. What a round for Tito Trinidad.
You get down and go away the ball.
going to show you, of course, the knockdown. And Bernard, you take it.
They in the clinch, and every time Trinidad and Joppy's in the clinch, he pulls out with his hand to get hit with the left foot. Every time he get hurt because he pulls out and he don't keep his hands up. He goes straight back. Same thing. He throws a punch, and when they break, he got his hands down, and he tries to run away with his hands down, and Trinidad capitalized on the opportunity. Again, he throws punches inside. He backs out with his hands down, and Trinidad takes advantage of it.
All right, again, the corner of Trinidad telling him, keep the pressure with boxing. Don't get desperate. You don't have to rush the knockout. They feel it's going to come. This is round five. Bob Sheridan with the reigning IBF and WBC middleweight champion Bernard Hopkins and our man Mark Goldberg here at ringside. It's been all Tito Trinidad. Perhaps generously we gave Joppy the third round, but Trinidad had Joppy down on the first and on Queer Street with only about a minute gone, a little more than a minute in the fourth round. And here we are in round number five. Question is, how many more heavy head blows can Joppy take in this fight? Don't forget, coming into this fight, Joppy was only down once in his entire career. That answers all the questions about the power of Tito Trinidad as a middleweight.
Yes, the power came with the welterweight division up to the middleweight division, but I see that Trinidad is not don't have that killer instinct. He gets guys in hurt, and then he brings them back again.
Well, he did that against Vargas, and then you pointed out, then he just beat the daylights out of him. He didn't panic, although Joppy made it difficult for him to finish him off by his instinct of just hanging on, which is nothing more than experience. A lesser experienced fighter wouldn't have been able to do that. I didn't think he'd be able to do it because he was really out on his feet.
Exactly.
This is round number five. Joppy trying to do the best he can. You see that little wing of Trinidad, his elbow, a left hand, left hook, catches Trinidad. He's hurt him again.
If there's any trepidation, you just made yourself $1 million.
Exactly, and I'm happy about that.
And I want some of it.
And I'm happy about that. We'll talk about that. And let me tell you, Trinidad had the perfect opportunity. Joppy, every time he hit Trinidad, Trinidad didn't phase.
Take a look at this now, Bernard, the end of the fight.
Here's Trinidad. Every time he hits Joppy, Joppy's hurt or he respects the power of Trinidad. But every time Joppy hit Trinidad, it didn't do anything. So Trinidad know he was the better puncher. Trinidad didn't respect William Joppy because Joppy couldn't hurt Trinidad in any time in this fight. Here we go again, a left hook. Trinidad knows that he's setting up to get everything in that left foot. And that's when he starts throwing it to the waist and then the right hand. Joppy took a beating.
He took an awful beating, and, I mean, you talk about convincingly beating a guy.
I'll tell you what, one thing I learned from this fight, I better keep my hands up.
What else have you learned from this fight?
I learned that Trinidad has to set the punch, and I also know that he's not as of an aggressive finisher as people might portray him to be. but I also know that I'm a bigger puncher than Joppy. I'm much stronger, I'm taller than Joppy, and he knows that he's going to be in there with a guy that look just like and fight just like Trinidad, and that's going to be the difference between me and Joppy.
When you fight him, you feel that you're going to turn this into a strip brawl. I mean, you really make it a tough fight, because that's the only thing that Trinidad has never been tested in, and really a down and dirty street brawl. Hang on, let's make it official first, and I'll have you answer that.
Gentlemen, we have the time of 2:25 in round number 5. Our referee in charge, Arthur Mercante, stops the contest. The winner by way of technical knockout, and he is the new WBA middleweight champion of the world, El Gran Campeón Puerto Riqueño, Felix Tito.
Answer that question that I asked you, Bernard, about do you have to get down and dirty and try to drag it into a street war with this kid, or can you outbox him?
Absolutely down and dirty. Not a street fight, but an alley fight, a Philadelphia alley fight. Trinidad loves it. You see him standing there, he's taking it. He fight one way, come forward. Trinidad is a guy, he might step left, he might step right, but he's going to sit there and try to wing you with that left foot and try to wear you down with that right hand, and that's the way he fights. It's going to be a ball burner between me and Trinidad, and I think a lot of people should tune in, pay for it, come see it.
They'll be doing that to be sure. Before I let you get away to take care of your other obligations, Bernard, I want to ask you this final question. Is there anything at all that makes you nervous about this kid? This kid can bang.
Well, yes, it's one thing. He might say something in Spanish that I don't understand, and it might be a bad word.
All right, we're going to go to Mark Goldberg, who has William Joppy. Go ahead, Mark.
Are they talking to Felix?
Go ahead, Mark Goldberg.
All right.
Take it away.
Thanks a lot, Colonel. We're here with William. William, your thoughts. I mean, obviously, you've got to be very, very frustrated. He hit you hard, he hit you often, he put you down. You couldn't have imagined this.
Oh, yeah, he's a great fighter. He got that punching power that I didn't expect coming up from 147. But like I said, I got to take my hat off to him. You know what I'm saying? He's a great fighter, and he showed that tonight.
Were you surprised at all that referee Mercante allowed that fight to continue after that second vicious knockdown, or the first one?
Nah, I wasn't surprised. I mean, he's a veteran ref, so you know what he's doing.
It appeared that it didn't take you long to get everything back together again, but, I mean, he was relentless tonight.
Yeah, he's a great fighter, you know what I'm saying? And, you know what I'm saying, it'll be another day.
At the fighter meetings, you said that you were worried about the left hook. Tell me a little bit about the left hook tonight.
I'm not worried about that. You know, I know that's his bread and butter, but, you know, he just got the better me tonight.
How do you feel right now?
It's still a bit discouraged, you know, being though I lost like that. I never lost like that in my life, so I'm a bit discouraged right now, yeah.
Where do you go from here? What do you do?
You know, back to the drawing board. You know, go back in the gym, train, and I'll be back.
You said that you didn't think that he'd be able to take a punch from a true middleweight, that he had never fought anyone like you before, that he some of the fights that he had won, he had just fought babies because they didn't have the experience. What did he show you tonight?
He showed me that he's a true veteran. He has a big heart, and I underestimated him a bit, but like I said, I'll be back. I have a tendency to do that sometimes, but like I said, I'll be back.
William, thank you very much. You're
thank
a true
you.
Champion.
You know.
All right, William Joppy, who took a little bit of a beating tonight, there's no doubt about that, but to hear him talk right now, Colonel, and to see him, you'd never know that he was down 3 times. Let's go back to the Colonel for a while.
Well, as gracious as we've seen him so many times in victory, certainly we thank William for doing the interview with us, because I know how disappointed he is in his performance tonight. But equally in praising Felix Trinidad, as we all must, I mean, this was unbelievable. This is what it looks like right now. Bernard Hopkins defeated Keith Holmes in a unanimous decision. Tonight was much more dramatic and much more definitive, as Felix Trinidad has knocked out, for all practical purposes, they call it a TKO, but had they allowed the fight to continue, it was a matter of an injury and one more punch, and that would have been it for William Joppy. So it scored a TKO. And coming up on September 15th, right here in Madison Square Garden, and you heard Bernard Hopkins, before he had to leave to go and do some work with some of the other networks here, say that it's not only going to be a dirty fight, it's going to be an old-fashioned alley brawl, not a street fight, an alley brawl. So we have that to look forward to. By golly, was I impressed with Felix Tito Trinidad tonight. And I'm sure, although a lot of macho comments from my good friend and the two-time champion of the world, and Bernard Hopkins, in that he has two belts, now he wants to put together the one that Felix Trinidad just lifted from William Joppy, and that'll all be in September. So you have all summer to look forward to that while Don King whips up some super heavyweight fights coming up during the course of the summer. Well, our man Mark Goldberg is going to attempt to get in there and get some comments through an interpreter with Tito Trinidad. So you stick right with us around the world, and we will have the comments. I know that Mario Rivera Martino from the San Juan Star will be anxious to hear this. Watch this last knockdown to really make it definitive. Bang! Look at that right hand right on top of that high cheekbone of William Joppy's, and then a following upright that sent him crashing to the canvas. And believe me, folks, that left hook, at this stage, his legs are already wobbled. He's back on his heels. See how he's dropping that left hand when he comes in? And there's just wide open for the right hand. And Tito wasn't satisfied with that. You know, they say he's not a good finisher. I disagree. I think he's a great finisher. I think he shows patience and experience of a 28-year-old fighter that is now the middleweight champion of the world, that has come up in weight. And this, as I said to Bernard Hopkins, this just might be his natural weight. Don't forget, this guy is tall. He's 5'11", and had to really train and work and punish his body to get down to the 147, probably for a couple of years longer, because he wanted to get the opportunity to fight De La Hoya. Then he moved up in weight and destroyed Reed and did a great job against young Fernando Vargas. And now he's just totally, I mean, he just totally dismantled William Joppy. I'll be honest with you, I've done a lot of fights, and I am surprised. I thought Joppy really had a shot to make this a much more even, a much closer, and a much difficult fight. In all honesty, there isn't anybody inside or outside of boxing that didn't expect Felix Trinidad to outbox him and perhaps catch up with him around the eighth or ninth round, but to drop him in the first and drop him again in the fourth, and then convincingly put him away in the fifth round, doesn't show a lack of fire to me. It shows exactly what his dad said. You don't have to rush this thing. Just, you know, be patient and let it happen and let it unfold. And that's exactly what he did. All right. Now let's go to our man, Mark Goldberg, with Tito.
All right. Thank you very much, Colonel. We're here with the guy who's got yet another belt. Can you ask Tito, first of all, how he feels, and did he think that he could put on a performance like this?
¿Quieres saber cómo te sientes tú? ¿Y pensaste tú que podías dar una demostración, una actuación como la diste?
Bueno, yo soy de Pesubo a dar una gran, a dar buenas demostraciones. De verdad que me gusta el knockout, y gracias a Dios le doy que por esta victoria.
I've always said, and this is the way I fight, I come to give a good demonstration, I look for the knockout, I love the knockout, and I knew I was going to do this.
Tell him that he looks as good as a middleweight as he has as a welterweight and a super welterweight.
Yeah. Dice que como peso mediano te ves igualito de bien como te veías en los super welter y en los welter. Te ves tremendo.
Sí, de verdad, yo se lo dije. Yo hablo siempre con mucha sinceridad. Le dije que iba a estar igual o mejor que los pesos anteriores.
I'm very humble, and I've always talked with a lot of sincerity. I've always told you, I'm going to be better than I used to be.
What do you have to say now about your next fight with Bernard Hopkins?
¿Qué nos puede decir de tu próxima pelea con Bernard Hopkins?
Esa pelea va a ser contra otro gran campeón, pero voy a demostrarle al mundo entero que por eso soy el mejor peleador del mundo, y voy a ganar la pelea de Hopkins también.
It's going to be a fight with another great champion, but I'm going to prove to the world that I am the champion and the best middleweight.
What would you like to say back to all the people in Puerto Rico?
¿Qué quiere decirle a la gente de Puerto Rico?
No, a la gente de Puerto Rico, tanto como a John Ruiz, otro boricua como yo, campeón mundial del peso completo de la AMB también, igual que yo, que somos grandes boricua y ¿verdad? Tenemos que poner a Puerto Rico siempre adelante.
I want to tell them that myself and John Ruiz are heavyweight champion of the world. We are good, proud Puerto Ricans, and we're going to keep competing and winning.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Y saludo a toda la madre. Un beso para toda la madre puertorriqueña.
A special hello to all the Puerto Rican mothers and all the mothers in the world.
The WBA heavyweight champion, John Ruiz, standing right next to him. Colonel, the man, Tito Trinidad never ceases to amaze. Wait a minute, we can't leave because the boss wants us to talk to John. John, very impressive tonight, wasn't he?
Oh, definitely. He's the best.
I'll tell you, you guys wear the colors of Puerto Rico very proudly. Let me quit before we have to get out of here. One thought now on the trip to China.
Oh, it's gonna be a great trip. You know what I mean? It's gonna be a third fight with Holyfield. Something I definitely would love to do, and here it comes. You know what I mean? I'm gonna go out there and prove that I'm the best also.
Thank you very much. Enjoy the night with your fellow countrymen.
Thank you.
All right, John Ruiz and Colonel. Like I said before, Tito Trinidad just never ceases to amaze.
Well, that's a double ditto for me, too, because Tito Trinidad and his performance tonight was extraordinarily impressive. And he surprised me with all the fights that I've done. And this was my 782nd world title fight on TV. And I'll tell you this, he really, really surprised me with his extraordinary ability in moving up the middleweight and totally dominating what I thought was a very underrated middleweight champion in William Joppy, a guy that defended his title 8 times, only knocked down once in his career, totally destroyed in 3 knockdowns by Tito Trinidad. And speaking of the knockdowns, we're going to show you the first knockdown, the second knockdown, and the final knockdown of the fight. So let's go to it, and we'll show you exactly how this thing unfolded. It's round number 1. Watch this now. You see Joppy back on his heels right here. He's staggering back. It was a left hook that put him down with a light right hand. Now Joppy's up, and look at how wobbled he is. This is a vicious knockdown. Here we are in round number 4. This is the end of the fight. And he'll catch him again with that left hand down. He bounces the right hand off it. Big right hand by the ear. Left hook, and down he goes. That was actually a terrific knockdown. And here it is at the end of the fight, where he's really on what I call queer street. And he's all the instinct and heart. He crashes into the turnbuckle of the ring. He's walking down, and at that stage, the count was about at 8. And referee Arthur Mercante Jr. said no. And he was right. Don't let it continue. Joppy wasn't going anymore. He gave him 2 opportunities, and that was it. So taking a look at the night, it's been exciting. The women's pound-for-pound champion is Christy Martin, who defeated Kathy Collins in what should have been a unanimous decision. One of the judges scored the fight, in my opinion, but they called it officially a majority decision. Then the IBF welterweight championship fight, Vernon Forrest defeated Raul Frank on a unanimous decision to win that championship in a terrific fight. Then we had the USBA heavyweight championship and IBF championship elimination fight, where Chris Bird totally dominated Maurice Harris in winning a unanimous decision. And the fight you've just seen, and a terrific, terrific championship fight with tremendous enthusiasm, the WBA middleweight championship of the world, where Felix Tito Trinidad defeated William Joppy, and the celebration continues. We want to thank in charge of transmission from Strategic TV, Diane McKay, Barbara Sykes, Mike Cutizano, our engineer in charge of the Chuck Haveley of Big Vision. We thank Pancho Limon for the ringside security, our stage manager, Andy Grill. For our associate producers, Randall B. Jones and Ira Glass, a great job by our producer, Johnny Perez. Maria Rusi, we thank you. For our executive producer, Rafael Torres, and for Mark Goldberg and our entire production staff here at King Vision, I'm the Colonel Bob Sheridan saying good night, everybody. Have a great night and a great weekend. Bye-bye from New York City.
big round, big round.
All right, keep your head moving, throw it.
We're going to show you, of course, the knockdown, and Bernard, you take it.
They in the clinch, and every time Trinidad and Joppy's in the clinch, he pulls out with his hand to get hit with the left foot. Every time he get hurt because he pulls out and he don't keep his hands up. He goes straight back. Same thing. He throws a punch, and when they break, he got his hands down, and he tries to run away with his hands down, and Trinidad capitalized on the opportunity. Again, he throws punches inside. He backs out with his hands down, and Trinidad takes advantage of it.
All right, again, the corner of Trinidad telling him, keep the pressure with boxing. Don't get desperate. You don't have to rush the knockout. They feel it's going to come. This is round five. Bob Sheridan with the reigning IBF and WBC middleweight champion Bernard Hopkins and our man Mark Goldberg here at ringside. It's been all Tito Trinidad. Perhaps generously we gave Joppy the third round, but Trinidad had Joppy down on the first and on Queer Street with only about a minute gone, a little more than a minute in the fourth round. And here we are in round number five. Question is, how many more heavy head blows can Joppy take in this fight? Don't forget, coming into this fight, Joppy was only down once in his entire career. That answers all the questions about the power of Tito Trinidad as a middleweight.
Yes, the power came with the welterweight division up to the middleweight division, but I see that Trinidad is not don't have that killer instinct. He gets guys in hurt, and then he brings them back again.
Well, he did that against Vargas, and then you pointed out, then he just beat the daylights out of him. He didn't panic, although Joppy made it difficult for him to finish him off by his instinct of just hanging on, which is nothing more than experience. A lesser experienced fighter wouldn't have been able to do that. I didn't think he'd be able to do it because he was really out on his feet.
Exactly.
This is round number five. Joppy trying to do the best he can. You see that little wing of Trinidad, his elbow, a left hand, left hook, catches Trinidad. He's hurt him again. You just made yourself $1 million.
Exactly, and I'm happy about that.
And I want some of it.
And I'm happy about that. We'll talk about that. And let me tell you, Trinidad had the perfect opportunity. Joppy, every time he hit Trinidad, Trinidad didn't phase.
Take a look at this now, Bernard, the end of the fight.
Here's Trinidad. Every time he hits Joppy, Joppy's hurt or he respects the power of Trinidad. But every time Joppy hit Trinidad, it didn't do anything. So Trinidad know he was the better puncher. Trinidad didn't respect William Joppy because Joppy couldn't hurt Trinidad in any time in this fight. Here we go again, a left hook. Trinidad knows that he's setting up to get everything in that left foot. And that's when he starts throwing it to the waist and then the right hand. Joppy took a beating.
He took an awful beating, and I mean, you talk about convincingly beating a guy.
I'll tell you what, one thing I learned from this fight, I better keep my hands up.
What else have you learned from this fight?
I learned that Trinidad has to set the punch, and I also know that he's not as of an aggressive finisher as people might portray him to be. but I also know that I'm a bigger puncher than Joppy. I'm much stronger, I'm taller than Joppy, and he knows that he's going to be in there with a guy that look just like and fight just like Trinidad, and that's going to be the difference between me and Joppy.
When you fight him, you feel that you're going to turn this into a strip brawl. I mean, you really make it a tough fight, because that's the only thing that Trinidad has never been tested in, and really a down and dirty street brawl. Hang on, let's make it official first, and I'll have you answer that.
Gentlemen, we have the time of 2:25 in round number 5. Our referee in charge, Arthur Mercante, stops the contest. The winner by way of technical knockout, and he is the new WBA middleweight champion of the world, El Gran Campeón Puerto Riqueño, Felix Tito.
Answer that question that I asked you, Bernard, about do you have to get down and dirty and try to drag it into a street war with this kid, or can you outbox him?
Absolutely down and dirty. Not a street fight, but an alley fight, a Philadelphia alley fight. Trinidad loves it. You see him standing there, he's taking it. He fight one way, come forward. Trinidad is a guy, he might step left, he might step right, but he's going to sit there and try to wing you with that left foot and try to wear you down with that right hand, and that's the way he fights. It's going to be a ball burner between me and Trinidad, and I think a lot of people should tune in, pay for it, come see it.
They'll be doing that to be sure. Before I let you get away to take care of your other obligations, Bernard, I want to ask you this final question. Is there anything at all that makes you nervous about this kid? This kid can bang.
Well, yes, it's one thing. He might say something in Spanish that I don't understand, and it might be a bad word.
All right, we're going to go to Mark Goldberg, who has William Joppy. Go ahead, Mark.
Are they talking to Felix?
Go ahead, Mark Goldberg.
All right.
Take it away.
Thanks a lot, Colonel. We're here with William. William, your thoughts. I mean, obviously, you've got to be very, very frustrated. He hit you hard, he hit you often, he put you down. You couldn't have imagined this.
Oh, yeah, he's a great fighter. He got that punching power that I didn't expect coming up from 147. But like I said, I got to take my hat off to him. You know what I'm saying? He's a great fighter, and he showed that tonight.
Were you surprised at all that referee Mercante allowed that fight to continue after that second vicious knockdown, or the first one?
Nah, I wasn't surprised. I mean, he's a veteran ref, so you know what he's doing.
It appeared that it didn't take you long to get everything back together again, but, I mean, he was relentless tonight.
Yeah, he's a great fighter, you know what I'm saying? And, you know what I'm saying, it'll be another day.
At the fighter meetings, you said that you were worried about the left hook. Tell me a little bit about the left hook tonight.
I'm not worried about that. You know, I know that's his bread and butter. But
for the featured bout of the evening, the second round in the World Middleweight Championship Series, and it's all brought to you by Don King Productions in association with Madison Square Garden, TVKO, and Budweiser, the undisputed king of beers. This bout coming away is sanctioned by the World Boxing Association. President Gilberto Mendoza, Supervisor Aurelio Fiengo, along with the New York State Athletic Commission, the Chairman Mel Southard, Commissioners Jerome Becker and Mark Kornstein. Introducing to you our three judges scoring this bout from ringside. From Johannesburg, South Africa, Stanley Christodoulou. From Montreal, Quebec, Canada, Guy Jutras. And from Ardsley, New York, Malvina Lathan. And the third man to the ring, our referee in charge of this bout, working in this, his 16th world title bout, Arthur Mercante. All right, fans, here we go with our main event of the evening, 12 rounds of boxing for the WBA Middleweight Championship of the World. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance and boxing fans joining us around the world, live from Madison Square Garden, it's time for the main event of the evening. Introducing to you first the challenger on my left, fighting out of the blue corner, entering the ring wearing red trunks with blue and white trim, hailing from and representing Coupe Alto, Puerto Rico. He weighed in at 159 1/4 pounds, undefeated in his campaign. action's 12 rounds of boxing schedule.
Let's get everybody out first.
Let's get everybody out of the ring first.
Just a chief second. Just a chief second. Good evening, Felix. Good evening, William. You both received the rules earlier tonight by the New York State Athletic Commission. I expect a nice, clean fight. Touch gloves. Good luck to the both of you.
Hey, how you doing?
All right, again, it's unified rules. No three knockdown rule, 10-point must scoring, no standing eight count. A fighter cannot be saved by the bell in any round. Only the referee can stop the fight. If there's any accidental fouls, we get into those rules as we get going. Bob Sheridan, along with Bernard Hopkins and Mark Goldberg here. Here we go. In the red, white, and blue striped trunks is William Joppy. And Joppy, the middleweight champion of the world, says he must pressure Tito Trinidad early. And that's what he will try to do. Tito, who has been in more pressure fights against De La Hoya, feels the right hand of William Joppy. Joppy digging early here now, Bernard.
Yes, he's digging early, and he landed that right hand. Trinidad is suspect to right hands.
Well, we'll see if he can land it more. A little bit side-to-side movement now. Circling around to the right is Tito Trinidad. Light left hand taken on the gloves of Trinidad. Joppy digs down, stares hard. Lights up that light left hand, taps Trinidad on the forehead. A lot of questions about whether Trinidad can step up and take the shot from a middleweight. We talked about the extended career as a 147-pound welterweight that Trinidad had, where he trained down from a street walking, probably 175. So this is not as big a jump as you may think for this guy who screws through a couple of weight divisions the past couple of years. Tito hasn't opened up in the first round yet, though.
No, he hasn't. I think that Trinidad is trying to get his rhythm. He's trying to get his punches in line. And that's when Joppy should do what he's just doing now. I mean, what he's doing now, he's throwing a jab, and he's trying to put the pressure on Tito.
Well, that's Tito. Tito with the first big left hook. He doesn't really land it heavily, but right back to the body is William Joppy. Joppy bangs high to the body that time. Didn't hurt Trinidad because he's in tremendous physical condition. Remember, both of these guys are guys that love to train, that are in great shape.
Joppy must get the respect from Trinidad early. And that's what Joppy realized. He realized that he got to come to Trinidad and try to put some hurt on Trinidad to make Trinidad respect him.
Almost 2 minutes gone here in the first round of this middleweight championship fight. And the crowd in attendance here in Madison Square Garden absolutely loves this. So far, this is Joppy's first round. He hasn't landed anything viciously, but he's landed more. He's dictating the flow of the fight. Nice counterpunch right hand. That time by Trinidad. You'll hear any time that Trinidad does anything, the crowd go absolutely crazy. Misses the left hand. Soars the right hand to the chin of William Joppy. Another right hand. I thought it might have buckled the knees for a second of Joppy, but he was just standing awkwardly. Inside of 39, 38 seconds to go in the first round. And now Joppy has felt some power from Tito Trinidad. Now this round is about even.
The time has changed. Trinidad now to know that he got Joppy hurt, and that he wants to go ahead and try to put more hurt on Joppy. Joppy must now at least use the jab and keep his hands up.
Big left hook is strong, puts Joppy down. He's back on his heels, and down he goes. And he barely wobbles. He's hurt. It's up to 4, 5, 6, 7. Joppy's going to have a tough time recovering in between rounds. Right on top is Trinidad. He's ready to go again. And he hangs on for life. And the bell ends. Round one.
Got a spirit of Joppy. He held Trinidad because he knew he didn't have anything and he was hurt. And he knew he'd be knocked out. That's the experience that Joppy has that Vargas didn't have, but he's serious in trouble.
Bernard, this is the first time that Tito has worn 10-ounce gloves. He's always worn 8-ounce gloves. That might be a reason why, right here.
It is a reason why. It was a left foot. You see where Joppy's hands was at? His hands was down at his waist, and he got hit with a left foot. Down again, he got hit with a left foot.
And he's really down. His eyes are rolling back. He's all jellied. Watch this now, Bernard.
He sets him up with a left foot, and then he throws the right hand and hit him with another left foot on the way back. Joppy hands is down at his waist.
That last shot was a vicious knockdown. I'm going to tell you, folks, no fighter can recover from a knockdown that heavy. Joppy is going to have a lot of trouble surviving the second round. This answers the questions of the power of Trinidad at the middleweight level.
He's definitely a middleweight, and he definitely has the power.
This Joppy could be his natural size, too, Bernard.
You're right.
All right, here we go. Round number two. Can Joppy recover? His legs are still loose in the knees. So my question is, he hasn't answered as far as I can see, the ability to recover in between rounds. And Tito knows it. He's jabbing more, throws the right hand, whistle past the left ear of William Joppy. Joppy takes a straight left hand on the jaw. Joppy's got his hands down. Remember what Bernard said about that. With those hands down, he's wide open for the left hook. He's trying to get the circulation going. Listen to the crowd chant Tito. Tito, round number two. Joppy already down in the first round. Tito just stands right in front of him, looking for the opportunity to land the big left hand.
Joppy right now has to be real careful. He's being aggressive, but he still don't have his bearings in his stage. If I was Joppy, I'd be dancing, boxing, and buying some time. Buying a round or two so I can get my bearings and come back and start fighting harder again.
Boy, he's really got his hands down low. He's wide open for that overhand, looping right hand by Tito. Tito clips him again upstairs. Tito knows that. Joppy's hands are extremely low, especially that left hand. He's open for the right hand of Tito Trinidad, and you've already seen him land the left hook. There's a straight right hand again. Landed right on the jaw of William Joppy. Joppy comes forward, tries to throw the uppercut.
This reminds me of Trinidad and David Reed when he was punishing him. This is the punishing right now. And Joppy must now try to figure out how he's going to survive at least another round or two to get his legs. He's moving, he's shaking his arms. He has to do this because he knows his body's feeling heavy and limp.
Action continues here in the second round. Those are the comments of Bernard Hopkins, the reigning middleweight champion. I won't say the other middleweight champion, but he has two of the belts. Looping right hand through by William Joppy. Tito being very patient now. Joppy now appears to be totally recovered. In the early seconds, he survived. I want to ask you this. Why didn't Tito attack him more in that second round in the early going?
Because Tito realized that Joppy is a full-fledged middleweight, and he just wanted to buy his time until he get the right left hook in there. Trinidad is known for not being having that killer instinct, but he will punish you and beat you up. But he's letting Joppy come back into the fight. And this will become now a struggle on who's going to give in.
Well, that happened in the Vargas fight, too. He knocked him down in the early going and was able to do it again, and then it became a war. Joppy really, really needs to knock him down to get some respect, as Tito is filled with confidence right now. Wow, with a left hand as Tito Trinidad. He goes back with the right hand, trying to get inside. Lands the right hand. Joppy back at his heels again. Joppy's got those hands down, and they're down low enough as he loads up the right hand and misses. Tito has got great positioning. He's just outside the powerful shots of William Joppy, which Joppy has yet to been able to land. In the closing seconds now, the second round of the fight. This is a good Tito Trinidad round, although he didn't lose his cool in the early going. Listen to the crowd chant, Tito, Tito, as the seconds tick away to end the second round of the fight.
I don't like the way Joppy keeps his hands down after exchanges. He got to keep his hands up. If he don't keep his hands up, even though he might hit Trinidad, he'll get hit with a left foot pouring out of the clinch.
But this is the way, you know, looking at some of Joppy's fights, this is the way his hands are all the time. It appears that his hands are always down, and I was even wondering prior to the fight the last couple days what Tito would do to take advantage of the fact that Joppy does not keep his hands up and sometimes keeps them straight out like this, almost a pitter-patter thing. Maybe he can do that against Jonathan Reed, but he can't do that against Felix Trinidad.
He can't do that to one of the greatest fighters that come up from the welterweights to the middleweights because his reflexes, and Trinidad is not going to let him do this.
Oh, yeah, good right hand right there.
And look what Joppy hands drops after exchanges.
He's wide open for that right hand, it appears to me, throughout the course of the first couple of rounds of this fight. Here we go, round three, Bob Sheridan with Bernard Hopkins and Mark Goldberg, the principals in the ring.
Watch your heads.
The reigning middleweight champion of the world, William Joppy Jr., along with the man seated next to me, Bernard Hopkins, who has two of the belts. This is for the WBA middleweight title. And Felix Trinidad wants the lift, and he had the champ on his rear in the first round already, and it was a vicious knockdown. All right, Tito showing patience here in the third round as he goes with a straight left hand. That's the right hand again. Hits Joppy, spins the head. Joppy comes back, throws a light right hand, and then a left hook of his own. Tito up on his toes. You can see the adrenaline rush as he faints left right in front. He's getting great angles there, Bernard.
He's stepping side to side, and he's getting great angles. He's throwing that left hook hard.
There's that right hand again. He sees it. It's open all the time. When Tito pressures him inside, Joppy has that left hand down. He's wide open for the right. Decent shot to the body.
Okay.
Yeah, and Mercante Jr., Arthur Mercante Jr. says, hey, keep it up, Tito. The crowd moves to tell them to keep it clean. But you were right,
elbow,
you know.
Tito.
He does some slick things with elbows and low blows. That's all part of it, Bernard, as you well know.
That's boxing. Once a guy hits you, it becomes dirty.
Wow, with the left hand. Nice defensive tactics and movements by Tito Trinidad. This is why he's such a good boxer. Two fading left hands, and Tito makes a miss. This is going to be frustrating for Joppy.
It's really frustrating. Look where Joppy's left hand at every time he's jabbed. And Trinidad realized that. Now he's coming with the left hook, and then he hit him with the right hand. The left hand is down at his waist, and Trinidad is countering that.
That right hand, almost a desperation shot by Joppy here in round number three. Tito just right on his fight plan, taking the best that Joppy has to throw and making him miss, and ducks underneath the wild right hand and then slips the left hand. He's right in front of him now, looking to throw a right hand. He'll set it up off the left jab off. If Joppy drops that right, left hand, he'll counter it with a right hand of his own. Watch it. As he comes in, Tito tries to move into position for the right hand. Instead, he goes for the left hook. That hook is a very powerful left hook. He has power in both hands. Great, great training. This Joppy lands a big cut. Joppy actually having a pretty good go here for the last minute or so in this round.
But he still have to be careful because Trinidad is waiting to, after the clinches are broken, to throw a right hand or a left hook.
One thing that's noticeable is the slip movement that Trinidad has with his head and body and trunk, and how he rolls when he does get punched. See the up and down movement? Joppy now landing shots.
It's clear that Joppy is not a big puncher because he hit Trinidad with three or four good shots and Trinidad didn't budge.
He just walks right through. Joppy comes with the uppercut.
Right.
And now he has the hang on. He's tired from throwing shots now. I don't know, Joppy may have won that round.
Yes, he won the round.
Tito lands the heavier blows again in the closing seconds. They're really going at it. Nice job by Mercante to get in there so nobody lands a punch after the bell. I'll tell you this, I like to see the American referees go in. You see the European referees, and they're so tentative. Things happen at the end of rounds that shouldn't happen.
Exactly.
I think it's evident also that Joppy is completely recovered from that first round, although the colonel mentioned that after the first 30 or 40 seconds of the second round that he thought he was recovered. But this was a good round for Joppy. I think the first round has already been forgotten.
Felix Trinidad Sr. has just told, as we take a look at this replay from the third round, don't get desperate. Just continue to fight. Stay cool. That's the coolness of being in big fights that's coming from that corner.
Oh, another thing that Bernard said in the third round, that he took a couple punches and hit Trinidad and didn't seem to really be bothered by the punch of a middleweight.
All right, here we go with round number four. This is scheduled for 12 rounds. Joppy tries to attack Trinidad. You heard Trinidad's dad say that, you know, just don't panic. Don't jump on anything.
Watch out. Let's keep it clean now.
Nice left hand in the face of Joppy. Joppy catches him with a light left hand. Trinidad seemingly doesn't have a lot of respect for the punching power of William Joppy. And again, you see Joppy landing shots, but it doesn't take any toll. Trinidad throws punches with bad intentions.
I mentioned earlier that Joppy has to be careful. After the clinch, he pulls out with his hands down.
And the same thing happens when they're in tight, too. When he steps back, he's throwing. So Tito throws coming in. Nice uppercut that time by Tito. Straight right hand again. That's the right hand again on the air. That time he might have rocked Joppy. He's back on his heels. Joppy's on his heels and he's hurt. That dog drops him. For the second time, he's down. That's only the third time in his career. He may not be able to recover. It's up to six and seven and eight and nine. His eyes are still glassy. They're going to let it continue. But Trinidad is on him now. This fight is going to end now. A minute 46 seconds left. It's too much time. And Joppy's actually out of his feet. He's hanging on instinct in the fourth round. This is a tremendous showing by Tito Trinidad.
Joppy is hurt.
He's really hurt. Joppy's hanging on. Tito's showing the patience. Joppy trying to gain time.
Look at the experience that Joppy has, even though he's hurt. He didn't do it, David Reed. He didn't do it. Vargas tried to fight back.
Tito punishes him to the body. Back upstairs. Doesn't just go head hunting, but the hands are down. When Joppy comes in with those hands down, Tito can rock him with the right hand. And McCanny's saying, stop holding. The guy is desperate. He has the hold. Tito looking to land.
Yeah, that's part of being a professional.
That's it. The right hand, light right hand gets through. And almost alone, it's just an instinct that Joppy's fighting now. He survived about 50 seconds now, and there's 55 seconds to go in this round.
himself and Trinidad, as you see smiling, have their own style. He wants people to know that he's confident, that he's ready, and that he's going to deliver. Bernard Hopkins is different. I come out with the mask. I don't want them to see my face. I want them to be in suspense of the execution that's going to take place.
And it works for you, and for him, he loves this. There are very few fighters in the history of the sport, Mark Goldberg, that enjoy the, let's say, the stage that this guy is coming to, which is the boxing ring. Listen to this crowd, Mark.
Unbelievable. You don't know what thing that, the one thing that amazes me, Bernard, this guy was a perfect welterweight. He looked sensational as a super welterweight. Now at 160 pounds, he looks like he was a natural middleweight.
Yes, he, you know, Trinidad has been walking around at high 60s, 68, 69, 70 for the last two or three years. And he couldn't fight it anymore, and he finally came up. If he was at the weigh-in, you see Trinidad looked bigger than Joppy. It was like a reversal. It was like Joppy was the guy moving up, and Trinidad was the guy sitting there all alone.
Is this the summit of where his body can go? Can he go any further up? Can he go maybe one more time?
I think he does. I think he can. I think he can get up to 68 and be comfortable. I don't see him fighting and being strong at 75 at light heavy. But yes, I see him getting up at least 68, 69, and still being effective.
He's still young. It's not like he's an old fighter and you can't put your body through that kind of metamorphosis anymore. So he does have that going for him. But he, no matter what weight he fights at, he just looked like he's a natural doing it.
And he has the boxing frame.
All right, I see Jimmy Lennon Jr. moving into position. And we should have the official announcements, because remember, we're going to have the Puerto Rican anthem first and the American national anthem second. And all that will happen momentarily, because it's Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we continue with our action at this time, I'd like to ask you to rise for the singing of the national anthems. In the ring, ladies and gentlemen, first to lead us in the national anthem of Puerto Rico, please welcome recording artists Amba. Singing sensation Margot Lenski.
Stripes and bright stars.
But there you see Trinidad, a little bit taller, a little bit heavier, 2 years younger, an inch and a half reach advantage. They're both coming off wins, and then you see it in the metric system. Unified rules, 10-point must, no standing eight, no three knockdown rule, and now let's go to our ring announcer, Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Welcome you to the world's most famous arena, Madison Square Garden in New York City.
City, the very first and big skyscraper that is kind of the signature of New York City. Coming up, Felix Tito Trinidad and William Joppy as we go to Joppy's dressing room. 32-1, one draw, 24 knockouts. He is the reigning middleweight champion of the world. But tonight he'll be treated like a stepchild to this guy who's undefeated. 39-0, 32 knockouts. A kid with a great jab and a great left hook. All right, Mark, you've got a feature on these guys.
Yeah, we certainly did. You know, Joppy Colonel is the champion, but like you said earlier tonight, it's Felix Trinidad that makes this fight. He's working to put his name on yet another new championship belt. Joppy, despite holding this middleweight title, WBA title, for some 5 years, is working just to get his name finally known, period, outside the world of boxing, and only one will succeed tonight.
William Joppy's time has come. Since winning the WBA version of the middleweight title back in 1996, all Joppy dreamed about was unifying the division and reigning as the best boxer in the world pound for pound. Tonight, he is finally on the road to fulfilling that dream, and he can thank his opponent, Felix Trinidad, for that. After all, it was because of Trinidad's move up to the 160-pound division that this middleweight unification series was created. Now Joppy has a chance to fight the marquee name and put himself in the position he's always wanted to be.
My goal, I want to get on that pound for pound list. You know, I've been champion for 5 years and I don't get the credit that I deserve because I haven't fought the marquee opposition. I fought guys that are great fighters, but they didn't have a name. So I need a Felix Trinidad. You know, Felix Trinidad had Oscar De La Hoya, he had the Pernell Whitakers. That's why he has that name. This is my dream come true, to show that I belong on that pound-for-pound list.
For Trinidad, winning this middleweight unification series would solidify his place in boxing history as the first ever universally recognized seven-time world champion. Seven world titles, champion in three different weight divisions, welterweight, super welterweight, and middleweight. That will truly be a huge step in my career. A great record in the sport of boxing. It's a record that can only be accomplished if Trinidad wins his next two fights. Tonight, he takes the first step against Joppy, who promises to give Tito everything he can handle and then some.
I'm going to bang with him. People tell me not to stand in front of Trinidad. I'm going to stand in front of him. You know what I mean? I'm going to give him slug. I'm going to box him. I'm going to do everything. I'm going to give him everything I possibly can do. I'm going to back him up. I'm going to back up. So, I mean, if I'm going to give Trinidad what he gives me. I'm going to take everything he gives me.
Joppy is a fighter who's always in great condition. He's a boxer who throws a lot of punches, a lot of quick punches. But on a negative side, in my opinion, he fights with his hands way too low. I'm taller than he is, so I'm going to use my reach advantage to the fullest and punish him in the early stages of the fight. WBC and IBF middleweight champion Bernard Hopkins will be watching tonight's fight very closely. He gets the winner on September 15th at Madison Square Garden, and he feels that this fight is not a lock for either Trinidad or Joppy.
Dangerous fight for Trinidad, but a winnable fight. Why? Because Trinidad, I think, is a bigger guy. Definitely hits harder than Joppy, but Joppy's crafty. He got that D.C., Washington, D.C. in it. Ray Leonard, slick, pest you all day. Joppy have to box a master plan. No street fight with Trinidad. A master plan. Boxing when you want to slug, slugging when you want to box.
Now, he's dealing with a veteran now at 160. So I think he's biting off a little more than what he can chew.
Yo creo que esta pelea no va a llegar a distancia.
I believe that this fight will not go the distance. I'm coming in ready for anything. I'm coming in ready to win. William Joppy is a great champion, but I also have to tell him that I'm coming to win, and I'm coming to take your title.
All right, there you have it, William Joppy and Felix Trinidad. This thing really is going to start right away because I don't know that the introduction to this fight, we're going to have one fighter come in, we're going to have the national anthems played, both national anthems, and then we're going to have the WBA champion William Joppy come in. I don't think I've ever remembered seeing a fight, certainly never covering a fight, but seeing a fight where this is going to happen. But again, it's a spectacular thing. It's Madison Square Garden, it's New York City, it's championship boxing, so anything at all can happen. Joining us for this fight is going to be Bernard Hopkins. And Colonel, I'm just the goosebumps are starting for this fight.
Well, as I said at the very top of the show, this is the type of fight, as you see Bernard Hopkins with us now. And Bernard, we certainly want to thank you for joining us. You are holding two of the middleweight championship belts now. Who do you want to win this fight?
Well, I'm rooting for Trinidad, not only because of the financial rewards, but the status that he had built up from the welterweights all the way up to the middleweights. But I know it's going to be a tough fight. I know Joppy is not going to just lay down and give his title up, but I think with the crowd here, the Latin crowd is giving Trinidad the support, and I'm looking to fight the best one that wins.
Now, Bernard, when you talk about the financial considerations, let's make it clear to the public, they're considerable financial considerations. We're talking about $1 million here. That's a lot of geld.
You're talking about $1 million rich or $1 million poor. And, yes, I want to fight Trinidad. Well, I want to fight Trinidad and hopefully win because he brings an extra $1 million to the pot.
Now, Mark talked about a couple of things just before the feature and just after the feature, and that was the situation with the national anthem. Felix Tito Trinidad, who uses the crowd to get juiced up as he begins to make his way in. I assume that this, as I see the Puerto Rican flag, that Tito is making his way in now because the crowd is going absolutely bonkers, but I see nothing but American flags coming in, and I expected to see certainly the Puerto Rican flags flying here, or maybe they're just bringing those in to set up for the national anthem. But nonetheless, Tito's going to be in when they play the anthem of Puerto Rico and the American national anthem, and Joppy's going to stay outside and make some sort of grand entry himself.
Yeah, that's something totally different than I've seen in my 13-year boxing. The way you look at it now, it looks like Joppy's coming out first. But I think it's more of a mental, more of a strategy, maybe on both sides to see who would get impatient, who would get off their game plan mentally. And when it's all said and done, it won't even matter. It's about who wants to be the undisputed middleweight champion of the world. And a lot of this is just a posturing to see who would give up mentally before the fight even starts.
Now, Bernard, as a former professional athlete myself, and you, of course, as an active professional athlete, I've found that in contact sports, once the first hit happens in football or hockey, or the first punch in boxing, you revert back to what you trained for, you're ready to go, and all this hype, you know, the butterflies kind of disappear, and it's down to business. I mean, this is your life. When you're a fighter, you're not frightened like a guy who might be having one fight in his whole life who was just threatened by some guy in the street. This is what you do.
Once the guy punches you, it becomes a fight. And most times it ain't a clean fight. But yes, you train hard, you focus, you run, you sleep, you eat, you think boxing. And yes, when the first bell ring of the fight, you go in there and you want to execute. You want to put all your work into the ring for that particular time and show the people that you are the true champion that you are.
Hey, well, I want to tell you folks that are watching at home, as you take a look at the audience in attendance here, this place is some kind of rocket. They came to see Felix Trinidad, and here is Felix Tito Trinidad, the great former welterweight champion.